Guys, welcome to the shop. Just Blake here with MJ's. Please check us out. What we're going to be doing today is going to be turning this into a printed circuit board. So we're not going to go over sourcing the materials. It's a whole different step. So the end product is going to be something that looks similar to this, but this is a defective one. So it'll look nicer than that. We're going to start out with cutting off a piece of FR4 copper laminate. You can get this stuff at your local Fadio Shack or Amazon or Rema. So the first step we're going to do is take some delicious alcohol here. It's the finest stuff you can drink. Place this on here and clean the board. You'll notice that even this board is already etched a little right here and here because of me touching it and leaving it. So this is just shows you how sensitive things are to corrosion or etching. So just the oil from my hands. One more time. I don't like that there. Looks okay, still shiny. Let's see where it goes. So after we've cleaned it, we're gonna let it dry. And we're going to start heating up our industrial iron here from the 60s. Get our tools ready. So what we're gonna need is good old hydrogen peroxide, 3%, and hydrochloric acid is what I use, and 33%, which is called muriatic acid. You can find these at the pool supplies section at any hardware store. Going to get a non or a safe container. We're going to need our two prints that we're going to be doing. This is a replica nano. This is very clean and dry. Our iron is on the highest setting, no moisture. We're going to make sure not to touch any of the things that are going to be transferred. You'll take your bottom pad here. Very dry. Place that over here. If you want to iron one side of this. Get a cotton pad or burn-free rag. Go ahead and stamp this down. Gonna hold this for about 30 seconds. Pressing firmly. Like without twisting or anything. Until the toner is transferred. These are printed on photo paper. And they must be printed through a toner printer or a laser printer, because it is not ink, it's toner, which is actually, I believe, some type of plastic. So as it heats up, it will leave the paper, which is that glossy paper, the photo paper, that's also has to be laser photo paper, and it transfers to the copper laminate, and you'll see in a second. Should be it. And so now you can see almost it's starting to show through. So we're gonna go over this smoothly, holding this pad down, and do each section. Holding for about 10 seconds, sliding off. Going to save this one for later after we clean this and drill the holes and etch it. This is single-sided FR4 copper laminate. You can get PC blanks if you want a big piece of it. You'll notice it's really starting to show through now. You're gonna wanna make sure that you go over the whole thing. So that it's fully transferred. So with a lot of the smaller components that are around here, especially, it can be tight spots, but this isn't really a tight fit, but there's a lot of things that if you don't press hard, you'll get a gap where there isn't the toner, and what will happen is that acid solution will, the etchant will take the copper off there, and there will be no, it'll be an open circuit. I'll just do it for fun, even though there's no water. Alright. It should be just about done. Go over one more time. And this is where you're gonna really press it in. Play around for a little bit. Just to show you, it's hot. At 120 degrees. C. Oh, sorry, 120 C. So that's degrees Fahrenheit. That was 220, so it'll burn ya. 220. Okay. I'm gonna go soak this in some hot water. You'll notice the water is already starting to soak into the paper, and you're not going to want to use anything else but your fingers and just rub this off the paper until there is no paper left, real gently. So we'll go back and rinse this one more time, and we'll see if it comes off. There she looks. Just turn off the iron. So this is what it's starting to look like. Like now, you'll notice it. There's a couple spots where there's a little bit left. Just gonna want to be patient with it and slowly focus. Gosh. Anyways, see some here and there. Just be patient. Use your fingers. Rub it. Gently. Continue just to wipe it off. Until you're left with a nice, you know, good looking piece. And in the end, it should look very nice. Don't worry about these tiny dots and rings. It should look very nice. And if it doesn't, do it over again. I'm going to go ahead and get our container here. The less you can make, the better. So, have a clean container. The bottom. Anyways, start with. Hydrogen peroxide. Let's do quarter cup. Quarter cup hydrogen peroxide. Two tablespoons. That's it. You're going to want to make sure to be wearing gloves and glasses during this, as this can splash into your eyes and blind you. Go ahead and drop our blank into here. Should see it start to change.
There's leftovers in there for you guys, okay?
Okay, thanks. Come here. Should immediately start to see the change. You notice that green. So this is muriatic acid and hydrogen peroxide. Both of them are acids. They'll eventually not be only good for about a day or so until this is bad. So what this is making is cupuric acid, which is good for its aldicide. It's good for your pool. So if you have anything like that, or any use for a fountain, you can dispose of it that way in small amounts. Just gonna agitate it a little bit. I like to use is a fine brush, old toothbrush. Gently get in these spots. Very gentle. And you'll almost see it start to happen immediately. So right at this stage, you're just starting to see the copper getting etched off and dissolved into this solution right at these edges. But you don't really see anything besides the discoloration. What's going to happen in the next, I'd say a minute or so, is you're going to see it completely. See that right on the edges? Already gone. And just with one brush stroke, you'll see it almost all go. Just coming off now like butter. See, real gentle. I don't really need to do this. This is just me playing with it. You can just kind of shake it or leave it, and it should be okay. rushing too hard here. I'm breaking some stuff, so we gotta take this out. That's it. Take some cheapos. Shake it off and it's just. Rinsed it. Notice kind of messed up there a little, but we'll see how it works. And go ahead and rinse it with some acetone. We're going to dispose of this properly. Neutralize it with some baking soda, but it is still considered hazardous waste. So I'm going to go wipe this off with some acetone and super. that's what we're left with. Should be very shiny and clean looking. Can see where I messed up here, so I'd probably not use this one. I'd probably redo it. But just for longevity, but this is just a, you know, that's how it goes. About half hour.
Thanks for watching.